I tell you, I could really turn this place around.
You trying to put me off? Because it ain't working.
Lucky shot.
So how's the wedding plans coming along?
Slowly but surely. You can't rush someone like Mel. She's, how can I put it? You know, she's like luxury goods. You've got to handle her with care. You wouldn't know where to start with a woman like that.
I've forgotten more than you'll ever know about women.
I know what I'm doing.
You handle women the way you play snooker. You talk a lot. You got nothing to bag it up with.
I told you. Slowly. But surely.
Well, 6 points clear. Feel it slipping away.
Still a lot of balls left on the table.
Yeah, with my name on them. Oh, Lisa tells me she saw Billy getting it on with Mel the other night in the club. It's all part of your strategy, is it?
Yeah, well, Billy's a dreamer, isn't he? You know, he's a typical Mitchell. Always got his eyes set on a big prize, but can never quite get his grubby little hands on it.
Yeah, well, if you won't leave her alone, you could always give him a nice big fat check. Worked with Ian, didn't it?
Are you playing or talking?
Well, one of us is playing, the other one's embarrassing himself. Look, why don't we just chalk this one up and call it a day? I hate to see a grown man squirm.
Just take the shot.
Slow death it is, then.
I can't tell you how much pleasure this has given me.
Yeah, we were easily pleased, didn't you? Look, why don't we stick a couple of hundred quid on this, make it interesting? Or we spent all your money on confetti.
Unlucky in sport, lucky in love, that's me.
Yeah, well, some people call it luck, don't they? Next time we'll have to play for the E20.
Next time, eh?
Yeah, well, I couldn't possibly go into partnership with such a terrible snooker player, could I?
All right, that's enough. I'll see you around.
Hold up. You got a month. You cover any losses and get some snooker practice in.
Jane?
Yeah.
I'll get that.
No, no, it's okay.
No, I won't.
Thanks. A little tip from me. Always be suspicious when a friend invites you round for dinner.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Would you like to have dinner with me?
I've already eaten, Billy.
Well, what about tomorrow?
Cheers.
What was all that about?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a quiet drink with my friend.
What, with him?
Yeah. Obviously, you don't know a thing about women, do you?
Babs, I am winning now.
Oh, yeah? And what does Steve think about it?
Well, if he can't handle it, that's his funeral, isn't it?
What's my funeral?
Nothing.
Billy's a happy little camper today. He's just pulled.
Look, I don't want to tread on anyone's toes.
With Mel. What was it you said, Bill? You're well in there or something, eh?
Look, at the Vic the other night, I know it looked like me and Mel were copping off together.
Yeah, you could say that, eh?
I didn't plan it or nothing. Steve, I don't want any hassle.
And why would I want to give you any grief?
Why? You don't mind?
It's not up to me, is it? I'll tell you what, though, Pepe. They make a lovely couple.
You want to buy me a drink?
Yeah, all right, yeah.
Cheers. I'll have a whiskey. Large one. All right, Phil.
Yeah. How's the snowball coming on?
Good, yeah. I've got a few ideas I want to run by you.
Okay. Want a drink?
No, it's all right. Billy just got me one in.
Billy? Put his hand in his pocket. What's it after?
He's in love.
Who with?
Ask Mel.
Just ignore it.
Oh, now, you should have seen these two in here after your dinner party. Going at it like hammer and tongs. Mind you, don't get me wrong, I think it's great. Billy doesn't have a lot of love for women.
he's joking, right? Mel!
Scraping a barrel a bit, isn't it?
Do you reckon? Well, after Steve, it is like a breath of fresh air.
Listen, I hope it works out for you, I really do. I heard on the grapevine there's a wedding reception booked here that's going begging.
Yeah, you can laugh all you want. Billy and me are going out this week. I'm just glad you're not bothered. See you later.
Yeah, look, don't forget, where's something smart tonight, okay? It's a posh restaurant.
You got it.
You're taking her out for a meal, are
you? You know what, Billy? You should have been a detective.
Yeah, you don't want to make you into a foursome.
No, I don't think so.
Only I was thinking of taking Mel out for a bit of grunting, aren't we? We might as well all go together, eh?
Yeah. Why not, eh? Look, I'll tell you what. See me outside my place at 7 o'clock.
Top man. Oi, Mel!
Yes, Bill? Don't yell at me like that, all right?
All right. Listen, you, me, Steve and that bird who he was just with, we're all going out for a meal tonight.
Oh, yeah, who says?
You don't want to miss a chance like this, do you?
Winding Steve up is not my sole purpose in life, all right?
I've arranged it all now. Oh, come on, Mel. My treat.
Billy, are you forgetting something? This is not real. Me and you, I mean. We are not really going out with each other, all right?
Yeah, I know that. Just enjoy your company, don't I? Very pretty girl there, aren't you? Steve's lady friend.
So what time are you thinking of going?
Delicious. Hey!
Steve got quite close to marriage a couple of years back, didn't you? With that bird, what's her name again?
Saskia.
Saskia, that's the one, yeah. Trouble with a capital T, she was. Can you pass us that ashtray, please, mate? Don't mind, do you?
Of course not.
Only I wouldn't want to ruin a terrific evening.
All these in-jokes, you three must go back a long way.
Oh, no, especially.
Well, not all three of us, anyway.
Is there some history between you two?
Not a lot.
History being the operative word.
He's not the one you married.
Do me a favour.
Would somebody mind telling me what's going on here?
Are you going to tell us, Steve, or shall I? Amy, you're only here because Steve's trying to make me jealous.
Oh, right. Oh, like you're not playing the same game, messing around with him.
Don't flatter yourself. I'm not trying to make you jealous, Steve. I'm just telling you how it is. I would rather go out with someone like Billy than spend 5 seconds with an arrogant git like you.
You used me.
Oh, shut up. Yeah.
You're sick. The pair of you, do yourself a favour and let them get on with it. You two deserve each other.
Oh, Amy!
Come on, darling.
Right, that's it. Billy, game over.
No, you're making a big mistake. I know how to treat a lady, I swear.
Thank you for your help, but I just don't need it anymore.
No, hang on. You can't just walk out on me.
Hey, she's my date. She's walking out on me, not you.
Spot on, Billy. You really think you're something, don't you? Well, let me spell it out for you, Steve. You can go out with who you want, when you want, for as long as you want, because I really don't care. Just leave me out of it, all right?
You heard the lady.
You just keep it shut. Mel. Look, I told you. I ain't interested in anyone else. It's you I'm waiting for.
How long have you got?
1st of March. It's our wedding day, remember? You idiot. You didn't seriously think you stood a chance with someone like Mel, did you?
What?